Okay, let's say you were given an equation and someone asked you if a particular number was the solution to that equation. The question is, how do you decide whether or not that number is a solution to an equation? Okay, here are the steps. First, in the equation, everywhere there is the variable, replace it with the number that you're given. Second, you're going to simplify each side of the equation separately using the order of operations. Third, if both sides simplified at the same number, then that number is a solution because then you'd have both sides equal. So first of all, you have to be given an equation. Note, if it is a solution, it might not be the only solution. So here is a question. Is 2 a solution to 3x plus 9 equals 2x plus 11? Now, the way I like to do this is I underline the entire problem. Okay, and then under the equal sign, I'm going to draw a bar. So it kind of looks like a big T. The reason I do this is to make sure that I'm really just paying attention to one side of the equation at a time. So on the left-hand side, I'm going to replace the x with a 2. So 3x means 3 times 2 plus 9, and then I'm going to use the order of operations. So that's just 6 plus 9, which is 15. Now on the right-hand side, I'm also going to plug in 2 for x and use the order of operations. So I have 4 plus 11, which is also 15. So when I replaced a 2, I got the same number on both sides when I simplified it. So yes, 2 is a solution. Here's another one. Is 6 a solution to 2x plus 7 equals 3x? All right, let's do the same thing. I'm going to underline the entire problem, and under the equal sign, I'm going to put the bar, and we're going to replace the variable by x. Right? We're going to plug that in for x. So we have 2 times 6 plus 7, and then we're going to see what this side simplifies to using the order of operation. 12 plus 7 is 19. And now let's do the other side. We're going to plug in 6 for x over here, and that gives me 18. They're both simplified to one number. No, not a solution. So no, 6 is not a solution. Right, let's look at this one. Is 5 a solution of x minus 3 equals x minus 3? All right, let's underline it. Put the bar. All right, so we're going to replace the x with a 5. So I have 5 minus 3 is 2. And then we're going to put 5 over here. 5 minus 3 is 2. So yes, 5 is a solution. Okay. Now, what if I had taken this same problem and asked if 10 was a solution? So we know 5 was a solution, right? So let's go back and see if 10's a solution. Is 10 a solution? Well, let's put in 10 for x. So I get 7 on the left-hand side. And I'm going to put in 10 for x over here. And guess what? 7's a solution too. So remember when I said that sometimes it's not the only solution? Here, 7's a solution, 5's a solution, and in fact, any number you put is going to be a solution here. X minus 3 equals x minus 3 for any value of x. Because the two sides are exactly the same. So you might notice that. So actually, the solutions, if later you'll get into this, we'll be saying that all real numbers are solutions. I mean everything. All right, let's try this one. Is 2/3 a solution of 18x equals 12? Well, let's do our thing here. Put in the t, and we're going to plug in 2/3 for x. So I'm going to write 18. Now, since I'm going to multiply it, 18x means 18 times x. Since I'm going to multiply it with a fraction, I'm going to write this as 18 over 1. And for x, I'm going to put in 2/3. Okay, and let's see if anything cancels here because we have to simplify it. 6. So I have 6 times 2 over 1. Well, 12 over 1 is just 12. You could first write 12 over 1. Now on this side, notice there's no variable at all. So there's nothing to plug in, and your answer is 12. So you got the same thing on both sides, didn't you? When you plug in 2/3, the equation is true, so yes, 2/3 is a solution. Here's another one. Is 13 a solution to x minus 6 equals x? Well, let's see. Underline it. And let's plug in 13 for x. So 13 minus 6 is 7. And here we put in 13 for x. And these are not the same. So when I simplified the left-hand side, I got a 7. But when I simplified the right-hand side, I got a 13. So nope, 13 is not a solution. And if you look at that equation, x minus 6 equals x won't have any solutions. You're not being asked that, but because that's like saying if you take a number and subtract 6, you have the original number. That doesn't make any sense. That's like saying, you know, however much money you have, if you take away $6, you still have the original amount of money. Doesn't make any sense. Let's try one where we have an exponent in it. Is 2 a solution of x squared plus 5x equals 14? All right, so let's do our usual underlining. And we're going to put in 2 for x. And notice 2 is in two places on the left-hand side. So we have to put it in for each value of x, because we're trying to find out if 2 is a solution. And doing my order of operations, 2 squared is 4 plus 10. I could do those at the same time because I'm going to add last, and that's 14. Now, the left side, there is no x at all. So I could write the 14 down here or leave it up there. Sometimes I do that right next to each other. I see what I got on both sides. Yes, I did get the same number. So the answer to this question is yes, 2 is a solution. All right, let's work on this one. Is 5 a solution of 2x squared minus 20 equals 6x? All right, now remember 2x squared does not mean 2x times 2x. The base is x, so only the x gets squared. So it's very important you're careful here. So before plugging in the x, I'm going to write out 2x squared is 2 times x times x. Don't have to do that. That's one possibility. Now if I'm going to put in 5 for each value of x, let's see, I have 10 times 5, that's 50 minus 20, which is 30. All right, now on the other side, we're going to plug in 5 for x, 6 times 5, which is 30, and yep, I got the same number on both sides. So yes, 5 is a solution. Here's another one. Is 3 a solution to x squared equals 5x? Try this one on your own. Okay, so we'll underline it as usual. Make the t and put in 3 for x. So we could either write x times x first and then write 3 times 3, or we could just put in 3 squared. And 3 squared, you could do that in your head, probably is 9 times, 3 times 3 is 9. And then we're going to put in 3 for x on the right-hand side. 5 times 3 is 15, and so no. No, 3 is not a solution. So, here's the cool thing about algebra, is that if you are solving equations, which we'll be doing, and you think you got a solution, what you could do is go back and check to make sure you're right. And this is exactly how you would check your work. You would go back and plug in that value for the variable and make sure you really do get a true equation, which means you're going to get the same number on both sides of the equation, the left side and the right side, after you plug it in. So that's what's really nice about algebra. If it doesn't work, then you know you made a mistake and you can go back and do the problem over again. In arithmetic, it's not like that. Sometimes you make a careless mistake and there's no way of checking except just doing it over and over again, and sometimes you make the same mistake over and over again. Algebra gives you the luxury of knowing whether you're right before you turn in your test. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.